Prins Padriu ishë I dërguar një posaçëm për Ballkanin në vitet 90 në Shtetet e Bashkuara të Amerikës dhe një nga përfaqësuesit e Shteteve të Bashkuara të Amerikës në Marrëveshjen e Rrugrit është sot në promovimin e librit të tij Paqja. Një libër ky që është promovuar më parë në Washington dhe në disa shtete të tjera të Shteteve të Bashkuara të Amerikës dhe sot në kujdesin e konsulatës së përgjithshme të Kosovës do të promovohet këtu në New York.
Si studenta e di shumë që kena pasur për të të rejtë të përmëtare, në të këtë të bëhat të përmëtare.
NATO, U.S. leadership, all of that. That was almost the exact opposite kind of direction. Russia was doing close to us in Bosnia. Just about time that changed. Not just one.
No, I understand.
It's a whole.
Yeah, but do you have like a specific number?
No.
I don't.
Kosovo and it's about Macedonia. So we have somehow the conflict that was resolved, although somehow fragile, and I don't like to use the word of some colleagues or politicians here that are saying a frozen conflict in Bosnia, but we do have it still on the agenda. At least with our good thoughts, and then we have a Kosovo, we all know what has happened in Kosovo. And Macedonia, which was, I have to tell you what I have read from the book, which is the legacy of these men. And I do have a little bit problem, Ambassador, how to call you. Ambassador, Colonel, or the fellow writer, or the colleague in that terms. But anyhow, Ambassador Perdue came to the diplomacy, I would say what I have read, I understood, by occasion, after having a career as a 27 years of intelligence officer, finishing his career in Pentagon as a very knowledgeable intelligence officer, because otherwise they wouldn't be that.
This falls on the 10-year anniversary of the U.S. Personally, a personal pride in the development of your country and the progress that it's made. There's still a lot of work to do, but Kosovo pulled out of a very tragic set of circumstances in 1998 and 1999 to end the peace in 2008. And I was very, very lucky to be a part of that. It is the history of the region, it is the history of American diplomacy for the breakup of Yugoslavia, particularly the three elements that I was involved in. Bosnia, Kosovo, negotiations in the open agreement, which was the biggest thing for me personally, this was the high point of American influence in Europe. I'll answer more questions that you may have. But I did want to say this is the memoir, because I was in it's also a history, a diplomatic history, a military history, and a political history for your country, Bosnia and Macedonia. And it's a commentary on how diplomacy works, how the United States conducts diplomacy, with some lessons that I think are important.
You all are agreement.
I understand that that was before the negotiations for Kosovo started, but how do you see as a diplomat and as a human being that 25%, which is the consensus, of Albanians in Macedonia don't have even 3% of the rights that 3% of the Serbs have in Kosovo? I mean, the asymmetry is so striking that even for somebody who's not from Albanian or from Macedonia or from Serbian, doesn't see it. And to end it all, do you think that we will reach peace, I don't want to say final peace, but permanent stability at least, once we realize that it's all about creating a balance that will last? Because the Serbs will always play the part with Russia. Even though, I mean, Russia sells them warplanes. What does the U.S. sell us? Nothing. We cannot even have an army, which would be a defensive army. So do you think that the time has come that the U.S. does the right things that it did 1945, 1990, in Iraq, when they went after the Baathists, they didn't let the Baathists in power. So what do you think about a more aggressive approach where we don't consider Serbia as an equal partner, but as a partner that has some liability from the past and actually, unfortunately, from current times? I mean, they pretty much control the north of Kosovo. And everybody knows it's Serbia. It's not the Serbs of Kosovo, but many of them have accepted Kosovo as their country. And we want Serbs to be a part of Kosovo because we believe that the state, we will be richer for having them, and for inside and outside when we have to do business and diplomacy and live side by side with Serbs. So what are your comments on that?
I like very much the point of yours when you mentioned the change. In this sense, I would really appreciate if you all can help us in the changes. Kosovo youngsters cannot go without a visa issue, and it takes a lot of efforts to all the thank you.
the current administration, as it has been continuously since I remember. We were liberated during the Clinton administration, Bush administration. And probably that's why Cosmo Story is a success story. Of course, there are many other specifics, and Kosovo is still a business. We are here today at this point not because the U.S. has changed, it's a new Kosovo. Ishte gatshësi që sot e bashkë me ambasadorin Salqia, me ambasadorin Pashtu dhe me Kuvetin, të kemi një bashkë bisedim për rrugën e shtetit të bashkëpunëtorëve dhe libri i Në Kosova është historie suksesi e intervenimit amerikan dhe na vjen të shohim që trajtohet dhe promovohet Sigurisht që ne kemi pritur shumë a shumë, dhe unë kam pritur shumë a shumë, pas 70 shkrimit të vitit 2008, u godutëm me realitetin e vrash të shtetë ndërtimit, dhe shtetë ndërtimit nuk është proces i lehtë, me gjitha duke pas parasysh nuk në matë sfidave, nuk në matë të kundështuarve, në Kosovat me gjitha ka shërkomarë për pare. Ente nuk e kemi ndërkuar Kosovën e ëndrave tona, me gjitha kemi ndërkuar të ndërkuar.
Ishte prapë një përmendim i librit Peace Makers, ose Pakëbërësi, një libër kjo që i kushtohet të paqes në tre vende, paqes në Bosnjë, paqes në Makedoni dhe paqes në Kosovë. Këtë libër është i shkruar nga ambasadori James Padrio, i cili ka shërbyer për Shtetin e Bashkuar të Amerikës, ka qenë përfaqësues i posaçëm për këto bisedime e paqes. Në Bosnjë, bisedimet e paqes, pra marrëveshja e Ohrit, dhe bisedimet e paqes që është vënë në Dayton për Kosovën. Pra, për televizionin e shqiptarëve të Amerikës, RTV USA, nga New York, dhe hirë, sinë.